facts and figures that, in fact, today, the armed forces is the most popular option for the youth. So the scenario in the last about 15, 20 years has changed. I may agree with you. In the early 2000s and even in the late 90s, there was a lot of rush for the corporates. But you'll be surprised to know that even the people working in the best of the corporates are turning back to the armed forces. The top engineers, even students from IITs, they are preferring the armed forces.
So, but do you agree with me in the introduction when I said that is the kind of civilian perception that is there?
This kind of myth perhaps got created over a period of time. Yes, there was a time, I may say so, in the early 90s or mid 90s, there may have been little armed forces may not have been a very popular choice. But the whole thing has undergone a change. Today, the armed forces provide you the best of the opportunities, the best of life, the quality life, best of pay and perks, and most challenging and adventurous life, which a youth looks forward to. And we will talk about it in the later part of the discussion.
Sir, but youth may look towards the armed forces life.
Yeah.
But there is a drag on them is what the civilian part of this adventure is about. By drag, what I mean is youth are generally either guided or interrupted by the parents, if I am not wrong. The parental perception of armed forces life requires some kind of a reorientation. I wouldn't use the word correction. Reorientation. Because they are from the previous generation. So the generation to generation advancement of the armed forces, the improvement in the quality of life, probably has not seeped into the generation of parenting. What do you say?
Subramanya, this part I may agree with you. Yes. And this lack of awareness is more prevalent in the South. In the North, if you go to the states like Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, even Rajasthan, and part of Madhya Pradesh, people, even the youth, the first choice of the youth is the armed forces. Even the parents are, very keen to send their children to the armed forces. Yes, the scenario may not be the same in the South. In the South, somehow, the awareness about the armed forces is lacking. And I will give you, wherever I have interacted with the youth in the colleges and universities, and when I talk to them initially, that how many are opting for the armed forces in the beginning of my talk,
hands don't go up at all.
Yes, you are right. You are right. I have seen my experience with the best of the university here in the Christ University, and one of the function when I was speaking to them, and you'll be surprised, there were out of a crowd of about 250 or 300, there were about 3-4 hands raised for the armed forces. And I was surprised myself. But once I brought out in the entire presentation, what is the armed forces, what it offers you, and what is the quality of life, what are the pay and perks, the facilities, the challenges, the adventure, you'll be surprised that towards the end, virtually 99% of the people, students, raise their hands for the armed forces. So it proves that there is a lack of awareness in the South. Gradually, it is now being taken care of by the armed forces also. And you will see a lot of quality kind of ad campaign, which is being taken up by the Ministry of Defense and the armed forces. So it's a matter of time.